Fox 16 News update tonight. The deadly apartment fire in Lonoke Saturday morning has claimed another victim. The mother of three was sent to a burn unit in Memphis. Hours after her kids arrived, she passed away. Fox 16's Rebecca Jeffrey spoke to the children she leaves behind and how they're handling with this devastating news. Rebecca.
Good evening, Steph. The answer is as best they can. The kids shared some memories with me, some things they're sad she won't be around for, but now they're holding on tightly to the family they still do have.
The devastation caused by an early Saturday morning fire is slowly being picked up in the city of Lonoke, but the news that three children lost their mother in that fire is still fresh.
That's going to be a tough one.
38-year-old Christina Paul recently moved to the 5th Street Apartments with her husband. Early Saturday morning, a fire broke out in the complex. Her husband died at the scene. Christina was able to make it out with third-degree burns covering 85% of her body, according to her family.
Well, I was shocked at first.
When Christina's ex-husband and his wife, Glenda, heard the news, they knew they needed to get their kids to her.
We jumped in immediately and went straight to the hospital from there.
18-year-old Rebecca Diamond says when they got there, they could only see her mom's face. But she sat down next to her and started reading the New Testament to her.
Reading the last bit of it, and that's when they came in and announced her that she had gone, was gone.
Now as a senior in high school, preparing for an early graduation in December.
I was really hoping for her to come to my graduation.
She's planning for her mother's funeral.
Losing her was like I had no one there.
But sitting hand in hand with her siblings and stepmom, she knows she's not alone.
The children are now in their father's care. No funeral plans have been made yet. The cause of the fire is still under investigation. Other families were also displaced in this fire. The Lonoke Police Department is now taking donations. Steph.